Hey, Wang! Hey, man! Right off the bat, man, I want to know what the hell that Vinnie Vincent email thing is all about that you were talking about last time.
Yeah, dude, it's crazy. It's about time I spilled the beans. So it's on my phone. I can't read with my glasses, so I transcribed it. So I got this email on November 22nd at 3:27 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. And Vinnie Vincent writes to me. Dear Bill Wang, hello, it's me, Vinnie Vincent. I saw the Sink and Wang show with you guys, and you mentioned the Vinnie Vincent invasion gang terrorizing San Francisco, which is unfortunate. I have nothing to do with this Vietnamese gang, but I'm willing to talk to the leader of the Vinnie Vincent invasion gang. I understand his name is Chan Ho Ko. To try to lower the temperature on this and violence on the streets of San Francisco. I have a soft spot for the Vietnamese people. Let me know what I can do. Sincerely, Vinnie Vincent.
Wow, man. Yeah. I'm sure he's got a soft spot.
Exactly, dude. So yeah, it was crazy when I got that shit. And yeah. Hey, man, you know, wow. Obviously he's heard about the Vinnie Vincent invasion game. So we can hopefully Vincent can, you know, straighten the shit out, man.
Well, more importantly, he's heard about the Sink and Wang show. He was probably doing some Google searches and was looking for Sink and some Wang, and he found us.
Yeah, probably.
That's crazy. What happened. That's what happened, man. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
Yes, you are.
Well, all right, man. Let's get into this, man. All right. Yeah. I know you watched it, man. I sent you the link last night and everything. It was the final Scab Kiss show. And, man, what a debacle that shit was. I'm so glad that we're over this Scab Kiss era. Man, dude, man, it just sucked. But unfortunately, the huge announcement that I was waiting for all day and all night was that Kiss are going to continue as a fucking avatar, man. They're going to be avatars of themselves. And I tell you right now, they ripped off Sink and Stanley, because Sink and Stanley was the first Kiss avatar. And you know this is true. So I'm pissed, man. They're freaking Paul Stanley stole my idea, man. Thinking Stanley got in his head, and he's like, oh, man, I'm going to make us all avatars and put us out there. Like, oh, man, whatever, man. Yeah. What do you think of all this shit, Wang?
Well, first of all, as far as the lawsuit, considering them copying you, if my attorney and business partner, Bob Reed, didn't fucking exile and bail to Honduras a few years back, he would have helped you out and sued the motherfucker. So that's another story for another time. I think the whole situation is, now if I was a Scab Kiss fan, I would have been so pissed, or just a neutral sort of Kiss fan. I would have been so fucking pissed off. That was just so anticlimactic. It was just, oh my God. There was no energy, and it was just, I don't know, dude. It was like,
I know, man. I know, and I'm reading all the comments and seeing all these posts from these current Kiss fans, and they're all pissed. They're done with them. They said the same thing. Same set list. No emotion. Man, they didn't even give a shout-out to Eric Carr, Bruce Kulick, Ace Frehley, Peter. They didn't give a shout-out to anybody, man. It was all about Gene and Paul. And after the show, they did these little mini interviews, and they had fucking fake Frehley, and he came up and he said, well, it's all about Gene and Paul. This was their baby, and it's all about them tonight. I'm like, fuck you, Frank Frehley. Shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
Freaking Scab Kiss, man. I'm just so glad it's over, man. I'm so glad it's over. So. Yeah. So I guess I get to keep making fun of Avatar Kiss next.
Why not, man? It just keeps going on and on and on and into eternity, you know?
Oh, my God.
You know, I'm glad I did not see that interview with Tony Thayer. That fucking jackal-ass bitch.
What a jackal-ass bitch. Oh,
he really
God.
Is, dude. He really oh, is. He really
he's
is.
Gotten full of himself, man. He yeah. fucking thinks he thinks he's a space man and shit. Fuck
yeah,
him.
Right. Right. And his Jay Leno jaw.
Well, that's a good segue into our next subject.
Yeah.
Speaking of the real spaceman, at least we have Ace Frehley, who's the real deal. No backing track, warts and all. He don't give a fuck. And he's got a brand new single out called 10,000 Volts. And, man, I think it's awesome. Wang, what do you think of 10,000 Volts?
I thought it was pretty cool, man. Fucking A. Yeah, it was pretty good. Was it snowblind or rip it out? No, because homeboy's in his 70s, not his 20s. But I have to admit, it's better than I thought it was going to sound. So there you go, man.
Awesome, man. Yeah, man, it just sounds great, man. Steve Brown did a great job producing it. Steve Brown from Trickster. That's right, Trickster, motherfuckers.
Yeah.
So, man, I think he did a great, great job, man. You know, the album artwork. Hey, Wang, what do you think of that album artwork?
Do you want me to lie or be honest?
Go ahead, be honest, man. We're always honest with each other.
I know, brother. I was just trying to be a little funny. I don't know. It looked a little 80s, you know, but maybe that's where he was going, you know. I mean, it's cool, but a little too dated. You know, I'm not trying to be a contrarian. You asked me a question. So it doesn't, you know, the music is what matters. But yeah, I mean, yeah. Is it the 78 solo album cover? No.
No. Well, nothing's going to touch that iconic cover. But Amen. Listen, man, the cover, the cover, it is what it is, man. It's pretty cool. It's Ace Frehley, man. Let's be honest, man. His solo album covers have really never been that great. All that matters is what's on the inside, the music. I mean, the new cover, yeah, it's a little AI looking, you know, but man, it's still Ace Frehley, man. And you know what I like about the cover, Bill?
What's that?
I think he's fucking with fake Frehley, man. He put those UFOs on there and then shoot them down with the lightning. just like Tony Thayer does in concert. I think he's like, fuck you, man. Check this out.
Yeah, maybe so, bro.
Oh, man, that's hilarious, man. But anyway, we're going to keep talking about Ace Frehley because guess what we're going to review this week, Wang?
What are we going to review?
You know what we're going to review? Why don't you tell everybody what we're going to review?
All right, we're going to review the album that came out on April 27th, 1987, Ace Frehley's 36th birthday. We're going to talk about Frehley's Comet.
Yeah, the debut.
Yes, sir.
Oh, man. And they really put some work into that cover, didn't they?
Yeah, no shit, dude. No shit.
That's what I'm talking about, man.
No, I agree with that. His covers are a little lacking.
It doesn't matter, man. As long as it's space themed or something like that, it's ace,
right,
man.
Right.
And Frehley's Comet debut, man, we're going to get into this because, man, man, I love it, man. So let's get right into this, man.
Yeah.
What's your number 10, Wang?
We're going to rate songs?
Oh, wait, this isn't a rating.
No. I could do that on the fly, but it would be a little difficult.
No way, Wang. What do you think of the first track, man? Rock Soldiers.
Yeah, it's. I love that fucking shit, dude. It's awesome. I mean, here's the deal, dude. I'm not going to wax poetic with this thesis and definition of each song. We're just going to broad stroke it. You know what I'm saying? Like good, bad, maybe a couple comments. So if you're mad that I'm not you, but the audience, oh, why isn't Bill Wang getting intricate detail of the song? Fuck you. So, yeah, man, it's Rock Soldiers. It's fucking badass. The video's cool. Brings me back to the summer of 1987, the good old days of being a young kid. Fun, you know what I'm saying?
Hell, it's
a fucking cool song, dude. Cool fucking great opener.
Yes, great album opener, man. I love Rock Soldiers, man.
Yeah,
Autobiographical. autobiography, yeah. Man, talking about Aeth's drinking problem with the devil driving with him and shit. Yeah. Wrecking his DeLorean, man.
Right, right. It's back in the summer of 83.
Hell yeah, man. Rock Soldiers rules, man. It's a great opener.
Fucking A, brother.
It's a great opener. Wang, why don't you take the next track?
Breakout. I think it slams, dude. It's same. I mean, it's just the same sort of situation. It's another great song. It fucking, I just love the groove. It's got some groovy riffs and shit. And the bass and drums sound fucking really fucking stellar.
Hell and, yeah.
Another great song off a really goddamn, my favorite Aeth solo, whatever, post 78.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Freaking breakout rules, man.
Yeah,
it's one of my favorite Aeth Freely solo songs, man, aside from the 78 solo album. This right. song is just slamming, man. It was co-written. It was co-written by the late, great Eric Carr and the original guitar player of Freely's Comet, Richie Scarlett, who they gave the shaft so that they could have a Paul Stanley-esque singer like Todd Howarth, who was great. Todd Howarth did a great job, no knocking him. But I love Richie Scarlett, man. He's got a great rock and roll attitude. Him and Aeth play awesome together. And,
yeah, they do.
We'll get to that on another episode.
Right, fucking.
So anyway, let's get into the second single from the album, and that's Into the Night, man. Man, yeah. Into the Night. Oh God, dude, I loved this song. I loved the video. I mean, I just listened to the original version for the first time by Russ Ballard. Russ Ballard, man, the same guy that wrote New York Groove from the band Hello.
Yes, sir.
But I just love this song, man. It's got a great vibe, man. Wang, what do you think about Into the Night?
I love it. And the thing about that is the video was recorded in my town of San Francisco.
Oh wow! I didn't know that.
Yes, sir. Oh wow, you didn't. Yeah, that video is recorded. I don't know exactly where, but it's a fact. It was recorded in San Francisco. I love it. It's a great song, and it's one of those songs that it just, if, as soon as I hear it, dude, it brings me back to exactly that summer. I mean, it's one of those songs where it chronologically it brings you to a specific time in one's life. So. I fucking love it, dude. It's fucking great, you know?
It does, man. It's got that ambiance to it, man, that nostalgia sound to it. I love it, man. I love it.
All right.
Wang. What's the next song we're going to talk about, Wang?
Something Moved.
Oh, did it?
Yeah, I think it was an earthquake. Oh, shit. The drums are killer. Bass, guitar, everything's great. Isn't this a Todd Holworth singing song?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
And written.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Like I said, the drums, and I'm not trying to hate on that dude. Okay. I'm not. I think his songs are a little too poppy. You know what I'm saying? But the instrumentations, the drum, bass, guitar, I love it. And it is what it is. The guy's a good singer, just not my cup of tea, but I'm not going to shit on the guy. He was very helpful in the Freely's Comet situation. There's no denying that. So I don't want to be disrespectful, but of the first four songs that we just spoke about, that would be the lower of the four. So, but still, it has its value. There are elements that are cool. The instrumentation's cool. So does a song suck? Fuck no, it doesn't suck. Is it great? No. So there you go.
Well, Something Moved, man. It's out there. I love it, man. You know, I got to meet Todd Howarth when he was playing with Cheap Trick. And, man, I've always liked the guy, to be honest with you. He's got a great vocal range. The dude could shred on guitar, man. He could do all that Eddie Van Halen tapping shit, you know.
Is that right?
But big deal, man. That don't matter for Freely's Comet. All that matters is the song, man. And I love the song, man. I think it rocks. Something Moved, man. Awesome.
Yeah.
Next song. We Got Your Rock. Right here. Yeah. Oh, man. This one's okay. You know, it's not one of my favorite off the album. It's a little lagging, a little dragging, but I kind of like it. I bet in the live environment, if it was sped up just a little more, it's pretty rocking, man. It's got that crowd chanting thing going. What do you think of We Got Your Rock, Wang?
Now here's a, there's a version. Now, from what I heard, back in the Black and Blue days, the beginning days, Tony Thayer wrote this song, and it was called We Got Your Cock. So maybe it's true. Hey, man, don't shoot the messenger. This is something I did, you know, just heard on anything. But no, back to this version.
Sounds plausible.
Yeah, exactly. I think you just nailed it. You know, it's a little too repetitive. But does it suck? No. Yeah, what you said, dude.
All right. What about the next song, Bill? You want to take that?
Yes, I do. That song I fucking love. That's got a groovy fucking, it thumps. You know what I'm saying? It thumps on a really killer stereo. I love the way that sounds. And badass song. Bam.
Love Me Right. Yeah, man, you know, I was listening to it. And, dude, I do dig that song. Like you said, it's got this killer little groove to it.
Yeah, dude.
And I like the way Ace pronunciates some of the words, like, hold me like your little teddy bear. I can't do it, man, but you know what I'm talking about.
Oh, fucking A, dude. Fucking
A. It's hilarious, man. It's got some really good hooks in it. Man, yeah. I like Love Me Right, man.
Me too, brother. Me too.
All right.
Bam.
All right, man. Going on to Calling to You, another Todd song. Man, I love this song, man. I ain't going to lie. It's poppy as fuck. It's got this syrupy-ass chorus, man. But I love it, man. He delivers it great. Man, I like it, man. Wang, what do you think of Calling to You?
I don't like it. It's, you know, I don't know. I just not a fan, never was, even back in the day.
So you prefer the Striper version of Calling to You?
Oh, hell yeah. Fuck yeah. Absolutely. No, and that's a gay ass poppy shit too, but I like that Striper song. Full disclosure, brother. Full disclosure.
So do I.
I know that's hypocritical. Wait a minute. You this gay song, da 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 da. But yeah, so there you go. Dilly dee. Bop, 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 bang.
Well, like you said before, man, there's different levels of gay, man. So.
Yeah, there really is. And in San Francisco, come on.
Oh, my God.
Dilly dee. You know what I'm saying? Dilly dee. Bop, bop, bop,
bop, bop. Hey, Wangaroni, you ain't the San Francisco treat, are you?
Well, if the Vinnie Vincent gang overwhelms me with 20 motherfuckers, I'm not going to have a fucking choice. You know what I'm saying? That's when I'll have my Glock 9mm so I can go bam, 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 bam.
They got to rub that trolley on you.
Hey, come on. Don't give him any ideas. Sinking Santa.
Oh, yeah, thinking Santa. Ho, ho, ho. Yes, right. Man, we'll get to that in a minute. But hey, Wang, what about the next track?
Not a fan. La, 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 la. Dolls, not a fan. I don't know. If I, if lovable Bill Wang Jr. was a little baby back then or a little kid, I would have, you know, played it for him, and he probably would have liked it, but, anyways, I don't like the song.
Dolls, man, it's not one of my favorites either, but you gotta give Ace some respect, man. He wrote it for his daughter, Monique, and has her on there singing it, so it was a really, really touching father and daughter moment, so I give him props for that, man. He wrote it for his daughter, and in that regard, it's awesome.
There you go.
So let's move on to the next one. Let's keep this rolling, man. Stranger in a Strange Land. Well, let me tell you, this ain't no Iron Maiden Stranger in a Strange Land. Man, I don't know, man. This one never really did much for me. It's okay. Ace tried playing it live a little while ago. You know, I don't know. They started playing it again, and then they dropped it. You know, whatever. But, you know, it's okay. It's okay. Not one of my favorite Ace tunes. Yeah. Wang, what do you think of Stranger in a Strange Land?
I like it. I mean, I don't know why I have to look at my little stupid note, but I think you pretty much nailed it, dude. I mean, is it Rip It Out? Is it Snowblind? Is it this? No. But it's not the worst song on the record, and it works. There's some cool instrumentation. You know, you could pick and choose, so that's always a cool element. You know, you can always pick and choose certain parts of songs that you like. So I think you nailed it, and there you go.
All right. Well, now the last song of the album, the instrumental, Fractured 2. Is it Fractured Mirror? Hell no.
Right, man.
He's never going to touch Fractured Mirror. That's a classic. But Fractured 2, it's pretty good, man. And out of the whole series of these Fractured and these instrumentals that Ace does, This is the one that closest resembles Fractured Mirror. It kind of keeps that same vibe a little bit.
Right.
But, you know, I dig it, man. It's a cool listen. You know, it's a good way to end the album.
I feel you, brother. Hey, let me show you something. See if this shows up. So this is, we did a concert thing. This was August 21st, 1987. Ace Frehley, this tour, opened up for Y&T. See if you can see the ticket stub. Is that coming through?
Back it up a little bit. Hang it, hold it right there and let it focus. No, I can't really see it. A little closer. Right there. Oh, no, you had it good back there. Back it up. Right there. Believe it or not, people can zoom in and probably see that. So, okay, cool.
Yeah, I just wanted to show that, that was a fun concert, dude. That was a blast. So, first time I saw Ace Frehley was this tour. You know, I was in love with the motherfucker since I was a little kid, and finally, not to hijack shit, but you know, when I was at this Creatures of the Night tour, about six blocks south from here. I had no idea that Ace wasn't going to be there. I was thinking, finally, I'm going to see my guy. And then we got to the front, and then there was a sign, Ace Frehley is in a car accident, da 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 da. So I just wanted to interject that. So there you go.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right, man. So you weren't that big of a fan of Fractured 2?
No, I thought you nailed it. I thought it was pretty cool. Instrumentation's cool. I think he went a little whack of Fractured 10, 5, 15, da 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 da, you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But that's his shit. It's that, him. So who gives a fuck what you mean? Yeah. It's all good. He's Ace motherfucking Frehley. He can do whatever the fuck he wants.
Exactly. And once again, man, his new single, 10,000 Volts, produced by Steve Brown of Trickster. Man, it's awesome. Oh, and just to let you know, I listened to Eddie Trunk the other day, and I'm sure you did too. And Ace was on there talking about his album, and he had PJ Farley playing bass on there. He's from Trickster too. So there
you
have it.
Really?
What I'm getting at is what's really cool is if he redid an old Frehley's Comet song that was a demo called Back in My Arms.
And PJ, I heard that.
PJ's playing bass on that, and Ace gave him props on Eddie Trunk. And man, to be honest with you, man, I love that song. I love the demo, and I always wish there was a better recording of it. So I'm really looking forward to hearing that one because I have not heard that yet. So that's going to be awesome for Ace fans to hear that.
Yeah, I'm really excited to hear this record. I hope and pray to God it's awesome, you know, and by the lead single. Sounds like it's going to be pretty cool. So, hey, man, I'm ready to give everything a chance, dude. So,
Hey, look, man. You know, Ace really ain't reinventing the wheel at this stage of his life. Right. But at least he's putting out quality music. He's 100% live when he plays. So fuck Scab Kiff and fuck this Avatar shit that's coming out.
Amen.
Oh, man, you know. Well, man, there's
Did you say scab kiss, scab kiss, scab kiss, scab kiss?
Oh, Tony Thayer fans! Yeah. Rip his head off!
Get out of here, Tony Thayer!
Oh, man!
You're looking at me.
Well, everybody, this concludes another episode of the Thinking Wang Show. Me Thinking Fantasy wishes you a great Christmas, and stay tuned for all the fun Christmas stuff I have coming at you very soon. Wang, this has been a great episode, man. Always a pleasure, man.
Fucking A, brother. Fucking A. We're keeping it strong, brother, man.
Hell yeah, man. Episode number 9.
Next and the big one is the next, number 10.
We're in double digits, baby. We're going to be in double digits.
Yeah. All right.
All right, man. Well, everybody, we'll see you next time on the Thinking Wang Show.
Bam.
This has been a Think Army production.
Bam.